On today's video, I'll be showing you how I did my copper metallic nail design here for this week's manicure. I used crystal nails, chrome gel polish, and for this gel polish you will need their special chrome no wipe top coat so it doesn't dull the finish. On my sample here, I do have a no wipe top coat that I applied over the base coat, so it has a very, very smooth surface, non-tacky surface. I'll be using that Finks gel to draw out the design, but we're going to go ahead and get started with the gel polish here. Now, with most of these chrome gels, it can be a little tricky to apply, as I said in my blog post. They are very thin polishes. However, I have noticed that the crystal nails actually tend to be a little bit more thicker and pigmented than, say, the jewelry gel or bundle monster gel polishes. It's best to do a three-stroke method. In this case, I'm doing left, center, and then right. This is a little bit more forgiving than the other chromes that I've tried. You can go over it just a little bit if you need to. However, you will see that it is still a little bit streaky. I'm not going to be too concerned about that at this point because I will be adding a second layer and that will kind of mask that a little bit. And then after we do our design in that clear gel, I'll do another coat over that as well. So I'm not too concerned about the streakiness right now. So I'll cure that in the UV lamp for 3 minutes, and after it comes out you'll see how much it smooths out and gives that nice smooth metallic finish. It's really quite amazing how much it changes just in that length of time. So here we're going to apply a second coat. Be sure to shake your bottle a little bit more since there are metallic pigments in there. You do want to make sure that that gets incorporated back into the liquid. So again, I'm using a very light touch with the brush as well. I'm trying to avoid any brush strokes, which you can see right there I got a little bit. So I'll just kind of go over that a little bit. Just kind of float it over that area. And again, we'll pop that back in the UV lamp for 3 minutes. Now, as I understand it through a friend of mine, you can cure this in an LED. You need about 60 seconds in the LED. You can see how nice that came out. Again, nice and smooth, very smooth chrome finish. And now I'm topping it with their special no wipe top coat. And I have found that with this top coat, you do need to move quickly as far as getting it on and then into the lamp almost immediately. And I'll show you why in just a moment. So once it comes out of the lamp, again, it's a no wipe. There's no sticky layer. So perfectly, you can call it a day and go on your way with this as is. But of course I'm going to add some designs there. Now you can see what happens if you go on to move on to painting the top coat over your other nails. I experienced this. I actually had to paint one nail and then flash cure it and then go on to painting the other ones. It's like the pigment started to float into the top coat and it totally destroyed the metallic effect. So once again, move quickly with your top coat with this particular product. Now I'm going to use that Finks gel, and I've got the Crystal Nails Zero brush. It's almost like a liner brush. The long, they have a long and a short. I have both, and they're both very, very nice. Now this gel is marketed as a clear foiling gel, and it works nicely for that effect. However, I found that because it is very thick, it does hold these lines quite nicely, so I just use it for this particular design. I like that. I like working with the clear because even though we will go back over the design with another coat of the chrome. If it doesn't get covered all the way, the clear, because your design is clear, it's still kind of reflecting that bottom layer. So I'm not too worried about getting an absolute 100% coverage by that next coat that we're going to do. So we're just going to paint our lines here. I'm going to do thicker there at the top and feather it out there towards the bottom. And again, this is entirely up to you how you would like to do your design. You can use any kind of other kind of thicker builder gel that you know won't spread once you get the lines onto the nail. So we'll finish up our design. This particular gel is LE curable for 30 seconds as well. I wanted to retain a 3D effect here, so I didn't go super thin with the gel. The only thinness was towards the feathering out towards those ends there. So now we'll do the bottom part of the design. And again, you can just use your imagination for this. I've shown some samples where I did some scrolls and some flourishes. I've seen some really cool designs with, kind of geometric line designs and, just whatever's in your imagination. Sorry that the camera went out of focus here. Because this is so metallic, it keeps throwing my autofocus off a little bit. So again, we'll pop that into the lamp. Now we're ready to go ahead and apply that last layer of the chrome over that clear gel. That gel does have a sticky layer, however, I'm not wiping it off for this. I found it really doesn't make a difference, at least for this little bit of art that we have on there. So right over it all. And it looks thick as it's going on, like it's going to just kind of settle into all those grooves and stay that way. However, because this is such a thin polish, it will get super thin and very, very metallic once it comes out of the lamp. So again, right back into the lamp. Again, UV is 3 minutes, LED is 60 seconds. You have that beautiful metallic finish there. So we're going to use the, again, I got my crystal nails. This is my zero short, just like the other one, except the bristles are a little shorter. And I've got on my tile here a little dot of TruGel Hazelnut and my favorite black, Black Velvet Lachette. And we're going to distress it with this. Now, those of you who read my blog post know that I used watercolors when I did the first design. And I found that the watercolors don't play nice with these no wipe top coats. And I actually had peeling the very next day. So I soaked off and I redid my entire manicure again. This time using the gel to distress it. And these two color combinations are almost exactly the same as the watercolors that I chose. So this came out very nice. Now, I just hope that because of the gel component here, that it will go ahead and at least last more than a couple of days. And what I'm doing here is I'm placing the black at the very top. And then I'm kind of feathering it down a little bit, and then I'm going in with that brown to give that lighter kind of faded look towards the towards those feathered edges there. I am very careful to kind of stay in between those lines. I don't want it to get onto the raised areas. We want it down into the recessed areas only. And because I did not top coat, over this third layer of gel. That's another reason why I'm being very careful. If you find that you get it where you don't want it and you end up wiping it off, I have noticed that it does affect that chrome gel underneath, so you want to be very careful doing this. So as you can see, the distressing really does make this design pop even more. Gives it more of a 3D look, even if you put enough top coats on there that it's no longer a textured look, it still looks like it's 3D. Now you could try pigments. I did it with acrylics on my previous metal manicure, but that only lasted about 3 days. So once again, I'm hoping that the gel, because it is a gel, will hopefully last a little longer. I'll certainly update you guys if that's the case. So there we have our distressing. A nice fade, kind of from the darker tips to the lighter brown areas towards the center. We're going to go ahead and cure that for 30 seconds in an LED lamp. And now I'm ready to add the metal stud along with the Swarovski crystal. I used an SS5. And on this sample, I'll just use my round hollow stud there that will fit that in there using our foundation, gelish foundation, as the glue. Now, if you'd like to know where to buy the studs, just come on over to my blog. I do have a nail art resource page, and I do have a page specifically for these links specifically for these studs if you want to check that out. And the Swarovskis, I've just gone to various websites where they actually have them by the stone. You can get lots of colors and different sizes for not a whole lot of money, so that's nice. So there's our accent with the stud and the Swarovski. At this point, you would just go ahead and top that with your the chrome top coat, which is, I have this sample here with the finished product. And for the accent nail, I'm not going to show it in here, take up that time. It's basically the same method using the clear gel to draw out the design. I simply drew out that top portion, kind of a smile line, and then using the gel, just kind of drew these teardrop shapes, graduating sizes there along the sides, and then distressed it as I did the other nail. And top coat, and you're all good. So I hope you have enjoyed the tutorial. If you guys have any comments or questions for me, just go ahead and leave them down at the bottom. As always, I really do appreciate everyone's support. And until next time, I will see you guys later.